Hello all, today's topic is heat engine. What is heat engine? A heat engine is a device that converts thermal energy into mechanical work. Examples for heat engines are steam engine, diesel engine, petrol engine, which is also called as auto engine. On the basis of how the thermal energy is delivered to the working fluid, the heat engine is classified into mainly two categories, internal combustion engine and external combustion engine. How the heat is taken from the boiler or in the chamber, it is divided into two categories, internal combustion engine and external combustion engine. Let us see one by one. So, internal combustion engine is again classified into two types, that is petrol engine and diesel engine. External combustion, example for external combustion engine is steam engine, where the heat is produced outside the chamber. Now, what is external combustion engine? In external combustion engine, the combustion takes place outside the cylinder or chamber in a separate chamber. From that, the heat is taken into to work. Steam engine is an example of external combustion engine, where the working fluid is steam. Here, the heat is absorbed by the working substance at constant temperature. The next type is internal combustion engine. In an internal combustion engine, the combustion takes place within the cylinder. The combustion is required to produce the heat. So, the heat will be produced inside the cylinder, hence the name internal combustion engine. Example for internal combustion engine are a petrol engine, diesel engine, etc. So, heat here in the internal combustion engine, heat is absorbed by the working substance at constant volume or at constant pressure. Whereas in external combustion engine, the heat is absorbed at constant temperature. We'll move on to internal combustion engine. Again, internal combustion engine are classified into two, spark ignition engines and compression ignition engines. What is spark ignition engine? Spark ignition engine is nothing but here the combustion process in each cycle is started by the use of external spark. In compression ignition engine, the combustion process starts when the air fuel mixture self ignites due to high temperature in the combustion chamber. It is nothing but in a petrol engine, say for example in petrol engine, in order to begin the ignition process, spark must be applied. Whereas in diesel engine, which is a compression ignition engine, by compressing the air to a high temperature, that catches fire when sprayed with the fuel, which is diesel. So again, spark ignition engine and compression ignition engine have two types. They are four-stroke cycle and two-stroke cycle. You might have heard about four-stroke engine and two-stroke engine. So four-stroke engine or four-stroke cycle is nothing but it has four steps to complete its one cycle. That means it has four piston strokes over two revolutions for each cycle. In a cycle, to complete one cycle, the piston has to move four times. So, it is called as four-stroke engine. So, when a piston moves up and down four times, it completes two revolutions. In other type, in two-stroke engine, it has two piston stroke over one revolution of each cycle. To complete one cycle, the piston has to move twice. So, that is about four-stroke and two-stroke engine. Engine components are shown in the diagram. You can see that in the right side is actually the upper side. There is intake valve in the left. There is exhaust valve in the right. And in between there is electrical contact. There spark plug or fuel injector will be used. and then the piston is shown here. This is piston and this is cylinder where the working substance is kept, and this is crankshaft and that is kept in a crankcase. So the components of the internal combustion engines are, first one, cylinder. We have seen in the earlier picture, the cylinder contains the working fluid or the working substance. Here, this is a cylinder and this is piston. Cylinder is nothing but, it is the central working part of the engine. The cylinder is very necessary to work the engine. The space in which the piston moves. The cylinder is the space in which the piston moves. Next part is piston. Piston is a sliding plug that harnesses the force of the burning gases in the cylinder. And other components are intake and exhaust valve. We saw in the above diagram, in the left side there is intake valve and in the right side there is exhaust valve, which is a doorway that lets the gases in and out of the engine. Intake valve admits the fuel inside the chamber and exhaust valve scavenges out the burnt out gases out, that means into the environment. Next part is connecting rod. Connecting rod or con rod connects the piston to the crankshaft. Then spark plug. It is an electrical device which is used to initiate the combustion. In a petrol engine, to initiate the combustion, we require spark plug. Or in case of diesel engine, to initiate the combustion, we require fuel injector. This is the picture of fuel injector. Next part is combustion chamber. Combustion chamber is this place. The end of the cylinder between the head and the piston face where combustion occurs, that is combustion chamber. Then crankshaft, which is a rotating shaft through which the engine output is supplied to external systems. That is connected to the flywheel, which is a rotating mass with a large moment of inertia connected to the crankshaft of the engine. Then we make use of these two terminologies very often in studying the working of a diesel or petrol engine, that is TDC and BDC. TDC is the top dead center. The piston, when the piston moves upwards, we call that position as top dead center or TDC. When the piston moves downward, that position is called as bottom dead center. We call the piston is in the position of BDC. And this is a sample of four-stroke cycle, may it be petrol engine or diesel engine, that completes its a cycle by means of these four stages. First stage is intake stroke. Second stage is compression stroke. Third stage is power stroke. And the last one is exhaust stroke. After completion of this cycle, once again that comes back to the first stage. That means intaking of the fresh fuel, that is intake stroke. Thank you.